Hi, I'm Eric and welcome to my channel. Today we're going to learn how to code a turret, which you can use to make games like tower defense or a tank game. First, we will delete the cat sprite. Next, we want to use the paint sprite icon. Here, we want to draw our turret. There's a few tricks to draw the turret. Let's start by changing the color. I want to set it to a cool looking gradient color. Select a circle and just draw a circle the size of, let's just say, I don't know, a 20 cent coin or a quarter. Notice that there's a little plus here. I want you to set the plus to be in the center of the thing. This will ensure that the turret is in the center of the sprite. This allows it to rotate perfectly on its axis. Next, I want you to draw the barrel. This is how we do it. Just draw a rectangular and just put it inside. You can look at the shadow, the center point again, center, and just put it there and send it to the back. And one more thing, you have to draw the barrel facing to the right. It's because the direction of any sprite when you start the game is always pointing to the right, or the default is 90 degrees. Let's put a turret at the bottom of the screen in the center, but do not put the center of the turret outside of the screen. Okay, let's start with the green flag. And then we're going to use the block point towards mouse pointer. Okay, so if I were to put a forever block around this, and when I press start, you can see that the turret is already following my mouse pointer. Excellent. Okay, the next thing we need to do is to make a new variable. We're going to call the variable directions. This is to track the direction the turret is pointing. This allows us to shoot a bullet in the same direction the turret is pointing. Let's start by using the set directions block. Okay, set directions, we can set it to zero because it's not where it's pointing. We're going to use the under the motion block. There's a block called direction. Okay, once we set that, you can see that on the top left of the screen, you will see the turret pointing exactly to where the direction is supposed to be. To the north or the top, it's just almost zero. And if you point to the right side, it's a positive 90. And if you point to the left side, it's negative 90. Excellent. Let's rename your sprite to turret. Click here and rename it T-U-R-R-E-T. Excellent. The next step is we're going to make a bullet. Go to choose a sprite and choose the ball. It should be in the first page that you click on. Okay, the ball is a little bit too big for the turret. Let's just reduce the size to say 50%. Next, we are going to use the green start block. First thing we're going to do, we're going to use the go to block. Go to turret. When you click start, you can see the ball going to the center of the turret. It is important that we keep the turret above the edge, as this is the start point. If not, it might trigger the touching edge block, which we will use shortly. Now we're going to use the repeat until. Repeat until touching edge. Okay, and we're going to use a move 10 steps block. Let's test it one more time. You can see the bullet is flying to the right side, which is the default directions. Okay, let's just replace this green flag with a when space is clicked. Okay, we want to point the bullet in the same direction as where the turret is pointing. Let's use the point in direction block. Let's just put it here before the thing starts, and we're going to use the variable directions. Okay, let's just try this. Is it working? If I move my turret to the right side, will it work? Yes, it will work. Excellent. Very good. Now we're going to use the hide and show button. Go to looks and put the height. We want to hide the bullet when it touches the edge, and we want to show the bullet as we press the space button to shoot. Let's give it a go again. Is it working? It's hidden when it touches the edge, and it shows when we shoot. Notice that the bullet appears above the gun. Okay, we will use another block called send to back. Okay, send to back layer. This will ensure that the bullet starts below the turret sprite. Let's give it a go. Okay, beautiful. Now that we have completed the turret code, it's up to you to make your own game. This is just the base code for a simple turret game. You can make a tank game, you can make a tower defense, or any games that you need to shoot something. Give it a go, and don't forget to share your game in the comments below. If you enjoyed today's video, I will appreciate you and give me a like. Till then, hope you enjoyed today's video. Bye!